and welcome back to Gallery Night's live stream. I realize I forgot to introduce myself last time. So my name is Victoria Gao. I'm the director of the Bannister Gallery at Rhode Island College and the board treasurer for Gallery Night Providence. Right now we are at the AS220 project space where we're gonna go inside and chat with Neil Walsh, the gallery's director, and a few working artists. So hello everyone.
How are you?
I'm good.
Welcome
to AS220. Could you just please introduce yourself?
Sure. Hi, my name is Rebecca Jeunesse, and I'm very fortunate to be here right now and show up my work, which is probably something you've seen because it's our city. Mm-hmm. And interestingly enough, the building you see over there started like this.
Wow.
So having the studio here at AS220, a working studio, I've been able to watch the city change. What I'm predominantly interested in is not just the color, but the way nature has been affected and how you see the birds and beside the fact that it was trembling that day under construction, you can see that many of the birds, and they're looking around like, you know, what's going on? What happened to my tree? Where's my roof? It's kind of bending.
So have you lived in Rhode Island for most of your life?
Yes, about 35 years. I came here right after I graduated from art school, from Boston, which was interesting. These are color notes. They're not finished paintings. So these are like my sketches. I get small canvases, and then I begin to just see how I can compose things. These in particular were done for experimental surfaces. So I have different glazes, some have sands, I've experimented with different tools on them, but they all are reference to what is across the street and the collaboration with nature and cones.
Large cones. Is this the Superman building?
No, the Superman building you will see in probably many of these paintings. As the structure rose, my studio is on the second floor. The Superman building actually disappears in later of my paintings when the structure goes up. This was interesting, it was a very windy day, and it was just a mess. And this kind of blew across, and I saw the building, and I went, oh, it's kind of mystical or whatever.
So these were all made while you were in residence here?
All of them, yes. Yep. And these, as I say, are my color studies. So what I do is I experiment with the color, and these, the color and a lot of the information I get is usually transferred to my larger work. So that definitely. The work is split in a couple sections, two actually. One prior, before COVID-19. You can see the activity, of course. Mm-hmm. And then as you move forward, there was the day. And this one, this particular painting, you begin to see that there's quiet. This was done 2 days after we were shut down in the city. Now when I looked out and walked the pedestrian parkway, there were no people, there was nothing, except nature. So I began to put those into sketches, coming from the color notes I had used, and preferably I was trying to do underlays of pink to give it some softness to it. I know it was quiet, but I didn't want you to feel, you know, really dread. And so this particular painting and the two in back of you were for, you can just see nature in the city, while the others represent what was going on, the building and construction. When I looked out just before we had the COVID shutdown, across the street there was a lot of activity. And I was doing some sketching, and I was thinking, wow, this is just so, you know, dense and all the stuff. And, you know, trees broken down, and I'd see different things, and they'd already dismantled trees from the end of the street. And there was this bird walking over everything, almost like, I'm really angry here. What's going on? So I did this like homage to him. This particular painting next to it was one that was done completely on the walkway, off the highway, and there are no people. There were squirrels and there was a bunny rabbit. I don't think the bunny made this one.
I hope that at least one sort of side benefit of being in quarantine for so long is that everyone gets to produce artwork and have time to really make work, beautiful
These
work.
These two pieces here are also sketches. They're larger because I was looking at night and thinking of how this felt. Trees had already been removed from this street here. And then I had this kind of thing of, there was this bird that kept going to this particular tree. And then I just made this composition that maybe the tree was looking at him, thinking, I'm sorry that your tree is gone, but. I think the composition represents definitely environment, but it shows the interaction that a lot of the wildlife has within the construct of the city as it changes.
Yeah.
Before there was glass and walls on a structure across the street, when there was lunchtime and the construction workers had to eat, unfortunately, just right out in front of the structure, and they no sooner left their lunch spot and the cones were there, and before you knew it, it was filled with all kinds of street and little birds chirping. I think the potato chip bags and the Cheeto bags were favorite. So again, this is the activity prior to COVID-19. This was just as they started digging. And fortunately, one morning I did see inside a I don't know if that's called a crane, a backhoe, literally a nest of it. And he was screaming, like, what's happening? So I just gave a constructed within the composition. And this is looking from my window. That's why you see this window effect from my studio. Again, you might be able to see that I'm using color for my studies to try and enhance the. And I, my early studies were with an impressionist painter called Henry Enchi. And he was very influenced by Hawthorne, and his teacher was Monet in the lineage of it from generations before.
Wow.
So I was very impressed with the color. And that color structure is not necessarily the technique of applying one piece of contrasting color to another. But in this realm, I wanted kind of wild color, which is what Henry referred to, wild. This is the only passage. So you can see the Superman building here, of course, was larger. Faintly, it begins, it's here. This was before the structure even started as they bought in. One night I was in the studio and I looked up my studio window. I saw that the machinery was coming in and all of a sudden there was a flock of birds that swooped through. So it's never to be seen again. I call this their highway because they were just, it's a beautiful.
Is this the word now?
I had seen that in a couple of graffiti pieces. And although I didn't realize it, I just put it in because I felt that this is what was happening at this point.
Mm-hmm. It's a great patch.
Well, thank you so much for walking us through your artwork.
Thank you.
Wonderful to see work that's very timely, but also just so vibrant and beautiful.
I'm glad you enjoyed it. Right. Always an artist loves to talk about their work, so you should know that.
How much longer are you going to be in residency if people are interested in contacting you? What's the best way?
I don't live here, but I have a workspace studio.
Oh, okay.
And I have to say that, and I would like to, if I could just put this on for a second, Zan Barry, who is a a studio here, created a piece by walking outside, listening to the sounds of, and there's a piece, part of his sound that goes with this, and then the music just stops. And all you hear is the chirping of birds.